Hello, my techie and non-so techie friends. My name is Dan Duran. I'm the Chief Technology Officer at Rhino Cybersecurity. This is Cybersecurity from the Trenches, and today I'm going to show you how to install Kali Linux 2021.2, released on June 1st, 2021 on macOS Catalina, that's 10.15.7. So let's get right into it. Hey guys, if you like my content, make sure you subscribe down below and click on the little bell so you can get notifications as soon as my videos are out. One thing that I forgot to mention is that we're going to be installing first Virtualbox 6.1 port 26. Obviously, you can't run Kali Linux, which is a Linux distro, on a macOS. It doesn't make any sense. You have to have a virtual machine. Usually you can use VirtualBox, which is free, or you can use VMware, whatever you like. In this case, we're going to be installing VirtualBox first. All right, so the first thing that you have to do is search for Oracle VirtualBox, and you'll land on this page here. Right, and just click on downloads, then you'll see OS X hosts right here. So click on OS X host, and you also have to download the pack, so the Oracle VM VirtualBox extension pack. So if you want your mouse and other appliances and devices to work, peripherals to work with your VM box, so click on all supported platforms here and download that as well. In this case, we're not going to do any checksums because this is demonstration purposes. So I'm just going to go and straight away install the VirtualBox 6.1.26 on my device. All right, so this is where I double click on the VirtualBox package and I continue with my installation. All right, once installed, you'll see this window says system extension blocked. So you have to open your security preferences for your macOS and go ahead, click on the little lock. All right, so I've done that. And you have to click on allow, right? So Oracle America Inc. and placeholder developer. Okay, once that is clicked, just leave the lock open, double click, and do the installation again. Perfect, the installation was successful. All right, so now you have VirtualBox. So usually what I do is just go back into my applications, find VirtualBox, put it in as one of my apps. Now I click on the extension pack. Right, so you'll see this little window that says install. So I'm gonna go agree. Enter my password again. Okay, installing extension pack and success. All right, so now we have VirtualBox installed. That's the first step. The second step would be to install Kali Linux. So just go to or search for Kali Linux downloads. And here it is. You should land on kali.org get-kali. And we're gonna pick virtual machines. So click on virtual machines and then click on VirtualBox. And this is going to download the 3.7 gigabyte OVA file. So I'll fast forward this for a bit until we are done with the download. All right, so now it should be installed. So I'm going to go into my downloads, and yes, here it is. So I'm just going to double click on it, and this is going to prompt me to the appliance settings. So do I want the MAC address policy? Yes. Now your base folder, so set this up, is usually users slash your username and then VirtualBox VMs. So I'll leave it the way it is. And additional options, import hard drives as VDI. So I'll leave this checked, right? So then the name, you can change the name afterwards if you want, or you can click here. So I'm just gonna call it Kali Linux 2021.2, right? And the product is Kali Linux, and I'm rolling 64-bit RAM. I can increase this to 496, DVD, sound card, yes, yes to all of these, right? Primary group, and then just import. Click on import. Yes, I agree to the terms and conditions. So this is gonna take a little while, 6 minutes. So I'm just going to fast forward this until we install the entire thing. So if you installed it correctly, this is what you should see. And all I have to do now is just press start and wait. Installing Kali Linux on VirtualBox on the Mac OS is extremely easy. For Windows, there's a little more complication. You have to set up different configurations, but for Mac OS is extremely easy. As soon as you install the OVA, then you can just run your application and it should be working without any problems. So here you just might want to click on the X's for your devices. Don't worry about those warnings. And here is the prompt for the login. Before I enter the credentials on the Kali prompt, let me just give you a little bit of a background. So in 2019, you were able to type in root and then tour as a password to get into Kali Linux. But since 2020 and now 2021, Linux or Kali Linux actually creates a user for you, so you don't have to use your root user inside of your Kali Linux. You can, of course, you can go into sudo su and go back to your root user, but this is just a precaution. Automatically, Kali Linux creates a user for you, and the username is Kali, right? And the password is also Kali. So Kali and Kali, and that should log you in. And there it is. Now let's test it out to make sure that everything is working perfectly. First thing I'm going to do is see if I have an IP address. So ifconfig, right? So there it is, inet. This is your local IP address. And I am also going to ping my Mac OS IP address. So let me just ping this to make sure that I'm communicating with my Mac OS as part of my NAT. And yes, this seems to be working fine. A couple of things that I can do. I'm going to launch my browser to make sure that I have access to the internet. So here it is. Let's just go to any website. Let's see YouTube, see if YouTube is working. And I'm also going to do fast.com to make sure that I have some speed, some bandwidth. So I can see that I have 11 megabits per second. YouTube is working very, very slowly. There it is, but I see it. Maybe it's because of the RAM that I have put into my box, which I can actually fix if I wanted to. The way you do it is just you go into your settings here, right? So click on settings. And once you click on settings, then you'll be able to fix your system, right? So system, and here you can increase it. I can't increase it. You have to turn off this instance in order for you to be able to change the RAM. And of course, I'm running one CPU. I can put it up to two CPUs. I only have 8 CPUs on this machine, so that's why it's running a little slower. But for demonstration purposes, obviously, I think this is more than good enough. I can access YouTube and other stuff. So thank you guys. I hope you had fun. Make sure you leave your comments down below and subscribe, and also press that little bell so you can get notifications once more videos are out. So cheers. I hope you enjoy. Next time we'll look at my favorite tools for using in Kali Linux, so we can start learning a bit more about Kali and Linux in general. So see ya next time.